They say hard work beats talent when talent won't work hard. But this is league. Everyone works hard. There are moments in your life that define not only your career, but who you are as a player. And this is your moment. This is your time to show everyone who you are. With one swing, with one pitch, you can change everything. For not only yourself, for your city, for your nation. The prize is in reach. Go get it. Beat the odds and beat the shift.
What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Beating the Shift. So as you all know, the College World Series is going on right now, and we are in the championship round, and it's the LSU Tigers versus the Florida Gators. Game one goes on tonight at 6. I think it's on ESPN. I'm not sure, but please, everybody, go watch. It's going to be a great series. Two very good teams matching up against each other. So today I'm going to talk about some of the high-impact players as well as some of the sleepers on these teams and who I think needs to step up and who I think needs to stay hot in order for their team to be successful. So first I'm going to talk about the Florida Gators. The two guys who I think are really going to have a big impact on how well the Gators play in this series is Jack Caglione and Wyatt Langford. So these two guys all season were ridiculous. I mean, Jack Caglione is a sophomore. He batted 325 on the season with 30 plus homers. But in this elimination round that they just got done playing, he batted 0.83 with 3 strikeouts and 1 hit. That won't cut it. I mean, he made up for it on the mound. He threw 4 1/3 with 1 earned run, 3 walks, 4 strikeouts. So he helped his team in that sense on the mound because he is a two-way. He throws 97, 98 off the mound. And he probably will start one of these three games. Three games that they're going to play against the Tigers. And he needs to keep that up on the mound. But he needs to step up hitting. Same thing with Wyatt Langford. He was their hottest hitter all year. He batted almost 370, 20-plus homers. But he only had 2 hits in this entire elimination round. And so these two guys are the key players in the Gator offense. And if they don't get it rolling, then they're really going to struggle to keep up with the potency of the LSU offense.
This episode of Athletically Declined Sports is sponsored by First Cup Coffee. Use code 80SPORTS to get 5% off all online purchases and subscriptions.
My sleeper pick for the Gators is Josh Rivera, I think it's how it's said. He had a pretty good elimination round. He went 4 for 12. That's about a .333 batting average, 3 RBIs, 2 homers, and only 2 strikeouts. He's not really a sleeper pick because he batted .360 on the season. He plays a premier position. So batting .360 at a premier position, that makes you very, very valuable. And I think he's also a sleeper because of his defense. He only had 9 errors on the season at shortstop. That's pretty good. He's had 1 error in this College World Series tournament, but his team won, so you kind of can just throw that error out the window. And so I think he needs to stay hot at the plate as well as stay crisp on defense, and he will help the Gators have success against this really stacked LSU team. So my 2 LSU high-impact players. You probably can guess the first one. Dylan Cruz. The Golden Spikes Award finalist to project the number 1 overall pick. But he did not have a great I say that. He had a decent elimination round. He went 6 for 20. That's about 300 batting average, which is still pretty good. He did have a home run. He had a couple RBIs. But that's not the Dylan Cruz that we saw all season. I mean, his stats, his highlights, I mean, it was just hit after hit, homer after homer, play after play in the outfield. And we just haven't seen that side of him in this College World Series. And so I think he, if he gets hot in this series, it's going to be really hard for the Gator defense and pitching staff to, one, keep them off the bases, and two, stop this LSU lineup from just steamrolling right over them. And I don't think this LSU, I don't think the Gators are going to get steamrolled. I think every game's going to be close. But if Dylan Cruz gets hot, it's gonna make it tough on the Gators. My next high-impact player is Tommy White, a.k.a. Tommy Tanks. He was the guy for LSU in the elimination round. 6 for 17, that's a .352 batting average, one home run, and it was a big home run. I mean, it was a walk-off against Wake Forest. Everybody had to have seen it. I mean, bomb 11th, 0-0 pitching duel, absolute shove fest from both Paul Skeens and Louder from Wake Forest. He will be, I mean, he's the spark plug. He's the guy in the LSU lineup. And if he stays hot, I think, I mean, as you see, it'll contribute towards LSU's success. So my two sleeper picks for LSU are not really sleeper picks. Again, I don't think anybody on either team is a true sleeper. I mean, every guy is a high impact player in the starting nine, every pitcher that goes on the mound, because these are all big games. But my two sleeper picks are Paul Skeens. That's the first one. And he's only sleeper because it's questionable if he's going to throw. I mean, he threw 123 against Tennessee in the first outing he threw, and he threw 120 against Wake Forest last night. And in those two games he pitched, it was 15 and two-thirds innings, 21 strikeouts. If he pitches, he's going to make it really tough for the Gators to get really anything offensively going, because he's done that to every offense he's faced this year. I mean, he's projected number two in the draft, another Golden Spikes Award finalist. I mean, that's why he's not really a sleeper. It's just he's a sleeper because it's only questionable if he's going to pitch. And in my opinion, I think he pitches game three in the winner-take-all game. My next and final sleeper pick is Trey Morgan. So he's a sleeper because of the offense and the lineup he's in. He hits behind Dylan Cruz, Gavin Dugas, and of course Tommy White. He has been a key player for LSU all season. He went 6 for 18 in the elimination round. He had two doubles, a triple, three RBIs, and he made the incredible play on the bunt, saving the run in the game against Wake Forest. I mean, that truly saved the game, in my opinion. And I think he's a sleeper because he's been hot at the plate. He comes up and he does his job. He gets the job done. He'll hit a ball off the wall. He'll run out of triple. He'll steal a bag. He'll go run down a foul ball. He'll make a diving play. He is, in my opinion, a key role player in the LSU offense and on the LSU defense. So overall, I mean, these are honestly two electric offenses. And in baseball, anything can happen. So it's really hard to say who's going to win this series, because it's probably going to be a dogfight to the end. And so in my opinion, I think it does go three games. And if Skeens does pitch game three, I think it'll be really tough for the Gator offense to get anything rolling. And I think the LSU offense is just too on fire and too potent through and through that for the Gators to come out on top. My pick for the 2023 College World Series will be the LSU Tigers. I know this was a short video. It was just a little, hey, preview, get everything rolling. But make sure y'all go check out AD on YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, and Twitter.